Leviathan here. Today I'm gonna start with a little question. How long do you think it takes to get pulled over driving a supercar with no front plates? The winner will receive a free t-shirt. Back to the story. Have you ever realized that when it comes to us car guys, we have some really strong and extreme opinions? There's never any middle ground. It's either you love it with a passion or you violently hate something. Let me give you a few examples. When I first got the McLaren 650S in silver, people hated the color. And I'm talking about they hated it with a passion, saying that I completely ruined the car. It has no imagination, it's not a supercar, it has to be bright and colorful and get attention. And that's not what I wanted, and the reason I like silver was because it's also so customizable, and if I wanted to make the car a little bit more interesting, I could easily do so with a wrap or a few cosmetic mods. Then, after getting pulled over a lot, I had no choice but to put front plates on the car. I was actually getting pulled over a lot, which brings me back to that question. And the reason I ask is because I did an experiment to see how long it takes to actually get pulled over driving a supercar in the city with no front plates. It's actually pretty hilarious and it actually backfired on me. So I will be posting that later on. Anyway, so once I put on the front plates, people hated it. I ruined the aerodynamics, I ruined the look, I ruined the entire car by putting on front plates. And I had no choice. It wasn't really so much the ticket, which is around $100, but not only do you constantly get hassled and pulled over, but then you start to develop that paranoia that every single cop you see will pull you over. Then when I did a reaction video with a friend of mine who owns a Nissan GTR in purple, oh my goodness, did people hate it. And the intent of that rap was really just to put a smile on people's faces, but some car guys got very, very angry. It's actually funny, a lot of the reactions in the GTR were very positive, and you didn't really have to be a car guy to appreciate that rap. It was actually very unique and very creative. And while I will admit it's a little bit tacky and not really to my personal preference, it is something which I do appreciate because in my mind I see it as a very creative expression of one's personality. Anyways, this all leads me back to the topic for today, and that is, did I ruin the McLaren 650S? You're probably asking, what did I do? Well, I decided to put some stripes on it. Not just to add another 300 horsepower, but to give it a bit more personality and style. That is essentially how the stripes on the McLaren look. I know there's gonna be a lot of people that hate it with passion, but if you have a better idea, just send it my way and it's something I can consider in the future. I am trying to think of new designs to put on the McLaren. I'm starting to find the stripes to be a bit of a cliche. And as promised, the hint for my question in the beginning is it's in less than 24 hours. So if you guess somewhere between 0 and 24 hours, you have a very good possibility of getting the answer right. So be sure to comment down below. And as always, thanks for watching. Until next time.